Welcome to a principal update and parent coffee chat. We have today with us our amazing assistant principal, Denora de la Torre. We have our incredibly talented parent support specialist, Sura Hassan. And we have our dynamic duo of counselors that are always there to help you with our SEL, whole child, focus, Mrs. Cano and Mrs. Piedra. And last but not least, the man that makes the show happen each and every Friday, Mr. Kent Haas, our Director of Media and Technology. So we're going to open up with our parent coffee chat with Ms. Cano and Ms. Piedra. Take it away, ladies.
Good morning, everybody. Hope you're having a good Friday. We know things are a little bit different, but I did want to say yesterday was so awesome seeing parents and seeing students drive by. Thank you, parents, for just hauling in that stuff for us, those donations. It really made a lot of people's day a good day. So here we are. Miss Piedra and I love to share information that we have because we need it in our toolbox sometime. We know our kids need it in their toolbox, so we've got some things for you, and hopefully they'll help you out. All right, you ready to share, Miss Piedra?
I am. I just need some sharing rights, some if I can.
You should be able to.
I see it. All right, Miss Cano, there you go.
All right, so we're going to talk about tips for working with a child experiencing anger. It happens, we know that, and it looks different if you're 1 year old or if you're a 15 year old.
So hoy vamos a presentar sobre consejos para trabajar con un niño enojado, un niño que está teniendo emociones muy fuertes. Mi es por Ms. Cano y yo y nuestra intern, Ms. Wilson.
All right, so this is one of the things that we've done with teachers. We posted last spring in our blend. Well, I don't think it was blend at the time, but it's called Lazy Eight Breathing. And our students are familiar with this, so are the teachers. My drawing is at school. But anyway, let's give it a try. We start in the middle. And we go down, we inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Back to the middle, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. And then we're just down. Hopefully that does a little bit of regulating for you. It usually works for me. And I think most of the time it works for everybody. They just don't know it, but it does happen.
Esta es una estrategia que hemos practicado con los niños y también con los maestros en la escuela. Y también queremos que los padres lo practican también. Se llama Lazy Eight Breath. Podemos decir el ocho flojo. Inspiración del ocho flojo. So lo que hacemos es, donde ves la estrellita, puedes empezar ahí. Y puedes empezar por seguir y inhalar así. Y entonces exhalar. So, inhala, exhala, inhala, exhala. Y yo recomiendo que practiquen esta estrategia cuando sus hijos están ya calmados. Si su hijo está enojado, está teniendo esas emociones fuertes, entonces los niños no van a querer practicar esto, van a querer gritar o decir cosas. Cosas malas, a lo mejor. So, es importante practicar esto cuando ya están calmados, porque ojalá cuando ya tienen estas emociones fuertes, recuerdan que esto es algo que le pueden ayudar.
All right, and here's another exercise that we've shared with adults and children. It's the finger breathing. A lot of teachers might even have this posted somewhere in their room, virtually, possibly as well. All right, so we are just going to follow our hand and we're going to breathe in and out. So we go up, inhale, Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Ooh, that feels really good. And I'm going to add one more little thing that I just read about. And I know I showed the two bosses there. And you take your thumb of your left hand, place it in the middle of your right, and just press. And if you hold that for a while, you don't have to hold it really hard, but it just helps you stay calm. Sometimes my eyes want to close when I do that. But just another little addition there.
So, esta es otra estrategia que pueden probar con sus hijos. Se llama el five finger breathing, so la respiración de los cinco deditos. Y lo que hagan es empiezan en la muñeca y entonces inhalan cuando van para arriba así. Ya cuando llegan aquí arriba, entonces puedes, al puntito, puedes exhalar para abajo. Inhala para arriba, exhala para abajo. Inhala, exhala. Y tenemos que decir a los niños que no lo deben de hacer como muy recio. Es muy despacito. A mí me gusta este porque tenemos cinco dedos. So por lo menos los niños van a respirar cinco veces, no solamente una vez. So a mí me gusta este para practicarlo con los niños. Ahí también Mezcano dijo que otra estrategia que pueden hacer para relajarse es agarrar la pulgada y ponerlo aquí en el medio de tu mano y puchar por unos segundos. Y pueden también respirar profundamente cuando hagan esto. Y ayuda a calmar el sistema nervioso de nuestro cuerpo. Es muy importante probar eso. Otra vez, yo creo que es importante probarlo cuando los niños están calmados. Y entonces recordarlos cuando tienen las emociones fuertes.
All right, and one last guided breathing. This is square breathing. And if you ever tune in with us when we Zoom with classes, you'll see us using some of these techniques. And I do just want to reiterate what Ms. Piedra said, that it's better to practice these when kids are in a calm state. So this time we're gonna start at one corner and we're gonna inhale and hold for the count of four. Ready? One, two, three, four, exhale. Hold for the count of four. One, two, three, four. Inhale. One, two, three, four. Exhale. One, two, three, four. Yeah. Your turn, Ms. Piedra.
So esta es la última estrategia que tenemos. Es la respiración cuadrada. So lo que hacemos es, tenemos que inhalar por cuántos segundos. So uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Y otra vez despacito. So uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Tenemos que contener. O tomar una pausa, 1, 2, 3, 4, exhalar por 4 segundos y otra vez tomar una pausa por 4 segundos. So, inhala, pausa, exhala, pausa. Y cada lado del cuadrado es 4 segundos.
All righty, and here we go. We know that. You know, all of us have anger sometimes. We can get ourselves really frustrated or worked out. Something happens. We have a trigger sometimes. And sometimes it just all builds up and comes out. So something that we can do is remain calm. And I know that's easier said than done, but we can practice that as well. So what we can do is model the behavior that you'd like to see. Try to keep that voice level. I know it's hard sometimes, because we're only human and we have strong feelings too. It's easy to become frustrated, so try to avoid the yelling, the sarcasm, or that tone that we get sometimes when we're annoyed, and we know what that looks like and sounds like. So just do your best to remain calm. And here's a phrase that I have used with kids at school And my daughter is really good at that with her daughter, even though she's a little toddler. And here it is. I can see that you're angry. That way it helps them increase their awareness of that feeling, and it labels it too, because it's a really good thing if any of us, but children in particular, because they're learning, can label their feelings and tell you, so then we can help them out.
So tenemos unos consejos también para ustedes. La primera es importante mantener la calma. So tenemos que modelar el comportamiento que a ti te gustaría ver. So sí, como padres queremos que nuestros hijos mantienen la calma, ¿verdad? Que pueden expresar cómo están sintiendo. So es importante para nosotros como padres a modelar eso. Y yo sé que es fácil ponerlos muy frustrados. Yo tengo un niño de 4 años, una niña de un año, y es muy fácil para yo también a levantar mi voz. Pero lo mejor que podamos, tenemos que tratar de evitar a gritar o usar el sarcasmo o molestarse en general. Y a veces vamos a tener esos tiempos cuando sí vamos a gritar o vamos a levantar nuestra voz. Y yo creo que en esos momentos es importante tomar un descanso, ¿verdad? Dile a su hijo, vaya a su cuarto, tomar un descanso. Yo también tengo que tomar un descanso. Y entonces, cuando ya los dos están calmados, puedes ir a hablar con su hijo. Le puedes decir, yo sé que mamá gritó, yo sé que me puso muy enojada. Y para mí eso no está bien que gritamos. Y perdón, disculpa, pero no está bien a... Y puedes decir lo que tu hijo hizo. So, si se dijo algo malo, si gritó, puedes decir, eso no está bien tampoco. So, podamos a practicar cómo usar nuestras palabras. Podemos practicar cómo calmarnos. Y puedes probar la frase, puedo ver que estás enojado, para aumentar su conciencia de la sensación que tienen. Es muy, muy, muy importante a conectar con nuestros hijos, que ellos saben que, como padres, sí sabemos cómo están sintiendo y entendemos. Y estamos ahí para ayudarles siempre. Cuando están enojados, cuando están felices, cuando están emocionados, cuando están tristes, siempre vamos a estar ahí.
All right. Oh, is it your turn now?
Yeah. Whatever you prefer. All
right. Let me just do this one and then we'll switch. All righty. So, her lead-in was perfect. It's be empathetic. Try to understand why they would be angry. You know, something that may seem small to us could really be, you know, frustrating for them or disappointing. Say they thought they had a play date with someone. And even though you think, oh my goodness, it's not the end of the world. But to them, that's something they were really looking forward to. And then they couldn't do that. So they get upset. Or, you know, maybe you had a plan like, oh, we're gonna stop at McDonald's on the way home, and then no, you know, we got to go to HEB so we can have groceries for the week. And just, you know, just acknowledge that. And then another phrase to try is, if that happened to me, I would be upset too. Like sometimes I'm thinking back to when my children were younger and I would pick them up from school, and they might tell you about something that happened at school. And, you know, just listening and acknowledging, oh, yeah, that wasn't cool, was it? Or, yeah, if I were in your shoes, I wouldn't like that either. Just that acknowledgement and letting kids know, yeah, mom or dad is hearing me. So that's really important.
So, consejo número dos, ser empático. Como les dije, intenta entender por qué se enojaron. Para nosotros puede ser algo muy chiquitito, algo que no creemos que debemos enojar para eso, pero para nuestros hijos puede ser algo muy grande. So, lo que puede ser pequeño para nosotros puede ser enorme para nuestros hijos. Y puedes probar la frase, si eso me pasará a mí, yo también me molestaría. So, puedes decir a sus hijos, puedes conectar con ellos y reconocer que sabes cómo están sintiendo. Y estamos ahí con ellos y vamos a ayudarles. Strategy number three. We're going to switch it up now. I'm going to do a little English. Strategy number three, help your child regulate. And one thing that I've learned about regulating it's not necessarily like always having to calm our bodies down, but just being mindful of what's going on in our body. So even when we're angry, we can still regulate, but we could just pay attention to those feelings, acknowledge they're there, notice them, don't try to push them away. So practice breathing with the child. That's one way to kind of get back that thinking part of the brain to regulate. Ask your child if they would like to take a walk outside. Again, another way to just take notice of what's going on in their mind, in their body. Offer your child some space alone. Sometimes our children, even us, we don't want to be around someone when we're angry, right? We just need that time to breathe, be alone. So offer your child some of that time. Don't be so quick to want to talk about it, right? If they're in that really heightened emotional state, they'll probably need some time before they can talk about it. Mm-hmm. And ask your child how they are feeling once they have practiced regulating. So once you've gone for that walk, once you've practiced that breathing technique, ask them, how are you feeling now? What are you noticing in your body? What were you noticing before when you were feeling that sadness or that anger, that frustration?
Ayuda a su hijo a regularse. Practica la respiración con su hijo. Y como dijo la señora Piedra, a veces los niños necesitan un tiempo para calmarse o nomás solito ahí. Es mejor que se sienten ese fuerte sentimiento porque si no, a veces pueden explorar. Or explode, ¿cómo se dice? So we don't want that to happen. Pregúntale a su hijo si le gustaría dar un paseo afuera. A veces si hagan un ejercicio o si muevan o escuchan música, otra cosa así, caminando, corriendo, le ayuda a tranquilarse. Ofrezca a su hijo un poco de espacio. Preguntan a ellos si necesitan un tiempo. ¿Necesitas un tiempo? Allí solita nomás. Eso es una cosa buena por unos niños. Sometimes, a veces, los niños necesitan ese tiempo para regularse. Pregúntale a su hijo cómo se siente después de practicar la regulación. Cuando ya practicaron, ustedes pueden decir, oh, ¿cómo se siente ahorita? ¿Todavía sientes un poco enojado? ¿O qué más puedo hacer? ¿O qué más podemos hacer los dos para ayudarle en regular?
Number four, practice active listening. Ask the child, what made you angry? What triggered you to feel that feeling that you had? Maintain eye contact. Nod to show that you are listening. Asking questions when appropriate, thanking the child for telling you what happened, and then inviting the child in to find a solution with you together. So really just giving your full attention to your child whenever or after this moment of anger or this really strong emotion has passed. Putting away the phones, turning off the TV, and really giving them your full attention to really show them that you're there, you're listening, and you're wanting to find some solutions together.
Okay. Aquí número cuatro, practicar la escucha activa. Eso quiere decir que debemos escuchar con atención, que estamos escuchando las palabras, viendo la cara del niño, su tono y todo eso. A veces yo sé porque somos... Tenemos que hacer cosas en casa, pero si estás haciendo otra cosa y no estás poniendo atención, a veces los niños se sienten, ay, no me están escuchando. So, pregúntale a su hijo qué hizo, qué le hizo a enojar. Mantenga contacto visual, míralo en sus ojos. Exprese a su hijo que está escuchando con atención. Haga preguntas cuando sea apropiado. Si están hablando de un evento o algo que pasó durante su día o la cosa que se le enojó, usted puede preguntar. Agradezca a su hijo por decirle qué le pasó, Dile gracias, hijo, por compartir conmigo qué pasó. Encuentran una solución juntos.
And then there's 8 ways to regulate anywhere. So just kind of recapping 8 things that just to keep in mind moving forward. Counting to 5. If you have really young children, I really recommend Daniel Tiger. He has some really catchy songs that I've actually heard some kindergartners at Travis Heights sing. And my son, when he was 2, he sang one of them. And it was just so funny how they just really remember it, counting. It's so simple, but put it in a song and they'll remember it. Take a deep breath, blow into your hands, put your hands into your pocket, identify the trigger. So again, what caused the child to be upset? Do that with your child. Make fists, so like tighten your hands, and then relax them. That can that's called progressive muscle relaxation. And if you look that up, if you type it into Google, progressive muscle relaxation, there's some really good guided videos for children. It guides you through like tightening your hands, relaxing them, tightening your arms, relaxing them, tightening your stomach, and just different parts of your body to really like sense that relaxation. Doing a body scan. That is just really like, you know, closing your eyes, noticing what are you feeling in your head, going all the way down, what do you feel in your neck, what do you feel in your shoulders, again, to just be mindful of our body and just kind of start practicing, noticing when we are starting to have those strong feelings. And then this one is a good one. Once calm, ask for a redo or reset. Again, I always try to do this with my son whenever he does something that's inappropriate. Once he's calm, I tell him, let's go back and practice the way we should have done it. And let's do it together so that he can start getting that, you know, those neural connections and start remembering, like, this is how I ask for help. This is how I tell my mom or dad I'm not happy or I'm angry.
Yeah. Ok, y aquí tenemos 8 maneras de regular en cualquier lugar, en cualquier lugar. Cuenta hasta 5 y practican con sus niños hacer eso. Pueden hacerlo en su coche, en una tienda. También otra vez respirar profundamente. Y a veces es nosotros que tenemos que hacer eso primero. Calmarnos y luego hablar o escuchar. Sople en sus manos. A veces decimos, ah, está soplando la sopa. Ponga sus manos en su bocío. Identifica lo que provocó el fuerte sentimiento, lo que causó que el niño se molestaría o se puso enojado. Haga puños y luego relaje las manos. Hay, si buscas ahí en Google, hay maneras y ejercicios para hacer eso como así, con los puños, o su cabeza, la cara, o partes de su cuerpo. Hagan una exploración del cuerpo. Si usted pregunta a los niños, ah, ¿dónde se siente eso? A veces identifican, oh, aquí. O en mis brazos, o en mi corazón, o en mi cabeza. Ellos pueden decir, y también, si quieres, puedes tocar ahí y respirar. Y así le ayuda a tranquilarse o calmarse. Cuando parece que se calmaron, pida lo que reintentan. Es como, en inglés decimos do-over, que ustedes pueden intentar otra vez. Cómo hacerlo, cómo regularse cuando se ponen enojado. Y también cómo usar sus palabras para que nosotros de padres podemos ayudarles con esos sentimientos fuertes.
And that was it. That was our recap, our last slide. I do want to just make a friendly reminder that Ms. Connor and I are doing a parent newsletter every month. So we've sent out September's and October's through Class Dojo. So we are giving you more tips on what we're focusing on with students and also what you can do at home, any good little tie-ins that you can do at home. And then we have these resources on our Blend page, which I think your children have access to, but you're always welcome to email us
Mm-hmm. Yep. And thank you so much. We really appreciate you coming and joining us. We know it's been tough and we're working on things. And I want to thank Miss Della Torre and Miss Navarro for helping us get some normalcy in there. Next week, Mr. Hawes, we're going to be getting ready for our monthly assembly. So make sure you tune into that and you let everybody else know. Yeah, tune into that because we've got some fourth graders doing something really cool with our intern.
Thank you, Ms. Cano. Thank you, Ms. Piedra, for such great information and helping our community with helping our Thunderbirds. Loved it. Those tools are so useful and I will definitely be using them for me personally and with my child. So thank you. So let me tell you how wonderful yesterday was. It was our wonderful carnival event and dance party. It was great to see everyone that was able to get out there. We had a rocking fun time. It was exciting, and I want to give a shout out to all our parents. Thank you so much for the amazing donations. Our bags were not scrimpy or scrawny. They were packed, jam-packed with goodies that fit everyone's tasty delights. So thank you so much, parents. Another great week at Travis Heights, no doubt. We are still adjusting to our new normal, but our team has been exceptional in making it work. Teamwork makes the dream work. Our attendance trends have been for week 5, 48 students. For week 6, 95 students. For week 7, 125. And for week 8, we round out with around 135. And I think yesterday was our highest attendance with 145. So parents, I know you're making a huge sacrifice. We appreciate that you are doing double, triple, quadruple duty at home. We know you're wearing many different hats. And thank you. Thank you for helping us so that we can help our Thunderbirds for the ones that need to come face-to-face and need that support. Your sacrifice has not gone unnoticed. And again, thank you for being so amazing and helping us at Travis Heights. We know you love your teachers, so thank you. We see it each and every day. Real quick reminder, if you have something to brag about, go ahead and submit through the RAVE, R-A-V-E, on AISD's website. You can plug in something special that you've seen your teacher do or how you appreciate them. They're real competitive and they like getting those little certificates. And so put a shout out. All you have to do is take a couple of minutes. We've set it up with our e-folder. So reach out and throw some goodness into the world of how amazing your teacher is. And then I will acknowledge and send them their certificate. So please do that. So beginning next week, November 2nd, these will be available for 100% face-to-face for students as far as coming in. However, parents, TEA has still, up to this point, said parents can remain remote for as long as they say it is possible. So just because the building will be open to 100%, you still have the choice to decide if you need to send your child face-to-face. We are asking that you still give us the 5-day notice so that we can accommodate, so we can make sure that we are, our safety procedures, allowing for social distancing, organization of where that student will be placed is, gives us the opportunity to make those adjustments. Typically we have 8 to 10 kids in a classroom. However, as more students come in, we are finding that we are having to use other spaces so that we can allow for the management of those students that are coming face-to-face. Rest assured, it is important to note that Austin ISD will offer the 100% virtual learning option again, like I've said, through TEA. As a public education entity, we must provide on-campus learning to anyone who desires to return in person. At Austin ISD, we're committed to doing this and as safely as we can for our students, our staff, our faculties, following all the guidance of Austin's public health. Please contact your teacher. They are your first means of communication to share if you have decided to change your plan up to this point. Families may change their choices. However, we definitely need that communication. If your child is on campus and would like to learn in a remote setting. We can accommodate that at any point in time as well. However, there is a one-time per grading period for your child to decide to change. So for example, we have now started the new 9 weeks. And if you decide for your family, you've tried the face-to-face, it's not working for you, and or your child is not feeling, for whatever reason, comfortable coming returning, then you can go remote. And then the second 9 weeks, the third 9 weeks, we would revisit and see if we would be able to try that again or remain remote. However, if your child is face-to-face and they want to remote, you can go remote at any point in time. It's just communicating with us so that we can best help support you. Please know that while we are currently on stage 3, according to the Austin Public COVID risk-based guidelines, we want to make sure we have plans in place in the event that we were to go back to stage 4. Some of the ways that we've prepared have included making sure that curriculum is designed and compatible with on-campus with the remote learning setting. Please understand that this means that students will receive consistent instruction regardless if they're engaged on campus or remote learning. The district and campus leadership are working together to determine how to prioritize students for on-campus learning in the event that we are advised or we have to begin limiting the number of students on campus. As a community, we can help to reduce the spread of COVID by consistently wearing masks when in public, frequently washing our hands and sanitizing hands, self-monitoring temperatures before coming to school, and staying home whenever possible. Increased spread in the community does not have to mean increased spread in our schools. And if we remain vigilant, we can continue to this fight against COVID. We will continue to closely monitor our effectiveness and limiting the spread at our campus and adjust our plans accordingly. Please know, parents, that we are here to support you in every way, and the safety of our students is always the first and foremost for all of us. So in order to be able to do that, thank you for adhering to the guidelines. Thank you for supporting us with the initiatives that we are pushing through. And if you ever have any questions, please feel free to reach out to Ms. De La Torre or myself. Stay safe. Take it away, Ms. De La Torre.
Buenos días, muchas gracias por estar con nosotros. Queremos empezar con decirles que ayer tuvimos un convivio excelente. Nuestras familias y nuestros maestros estuvieron muy contentos de recibir a todos los niños que pasaron en nuestra caravana, celebrando el otoño y recibiendo sus bolsitas de dulces o de snacks que traían adentro. Hemos tenido una excelente semana en Travis Heights. Continuamos ajustándonos a nuestra nueva realidad, pero nuestro equipo que tenemos aquí ha trabajado excepcional y estamos trabajando juntos para que todos tengamos una buena experiencia aquí en Travis Heights. La asistencia de nuestros alumnos ha seguido subiendo. La primera semana, que fue la semana número 5, tuvimos 48 alumnos. La semana número 6, tuvimos 95 alumnos. La semana número 7, tuvimos 125. Y esta semana hemos tenido aproximadamente entre 135 y ayer, el número más alto, 145. Empezando la siguiente semana, que es la semana del 2 de noviembre, el edificio estará abierto a una capacidad de 100%. Lo que quiere decir es de que eso exactamente, el edificio está abierto para recibir a 100% de nuestros alumnos. Pero también quiere decir que los padres tienen todavía la decisión de quedarse en casa, asistiendo a la escuela remotamente. Esa decisión sigue viable para los padres. Ahora, si nuestras familias deciden regresar a la escuela y presentarse en persona, como quiera seguimos pidiendo los 5 días para poder acomodar seguramente a nuestros alumnos que van a venir al edificio. Entonces, nuestras maestras han estado comunicándose con nuestras familias para ver cuáles familias deciden regresar a la escuela el 2 de noviembre, que viene siendo el lunes. Ahora, con eso también va de que nuestras familias tienen la oportunidad de hacer un cambio cada 9 semanas. Así es que, por ejemplo, si una familia decide venir a asistir a la escuela cara a cara, al venir al edificio, pero después deciden que esa no es la mejor opción para su estudiante y si quieren regresarse a remotamente, esa decisión se puede hacer y se puede hacer a cualquier momento. Nada más que la consecuencia de eso es de que si después deciden que quieren regresar al edificio porque ya hemos hecho un cambio durante las 9 semanas, eso es nada más un cambio cada 9 semanas. Ahora, la seguridad de nuestros estudiantes y nuestro personal sigue siendo una prioridad para nosotros como Travis Heights, pero también para el distrito. Entonces, queremos asegurarles que estamos siguiendo al 100% todos los protocolos de seguridad. La Agencia Educativa de Texas continúa con la posibilidad de los estudiantes quedándose en casa o viniendo al edificio remotamente. La decisión sigue siendo de la familia para ver qué gustan hacer, regresar al edificio o quedarse con la tecnología que tienen en casa. Otra vez les menciono que la decisión es de las familias, pueden quedarse en casa o pueden venir al edificio, pero nada más, solamente es una decisión o un cambio cada 9 semanas. Y para mejor preparar el área donde va a estar nuestro alumno, les pedimos los 5 días de anticipo para poder hacer la transición del estudiante a la escuela. También les decimos que sigue la seguridad o la posibilidad de los casos de COVID que sigan subiendo. Así es que les pedimos que estemos preparados con la tecnología y el acceso al internet, que le decimos el hotspot para su familia, en caso de que tengamos que hacer una transición a todos estudiando o aprendiendo de casa. Okay, I think we're caught up, Ms. Navarro.
All right, prospective parent tours. So even though we are having to change things a little bit, we are still having these parent virtual tours. Those will take place on November the 13th at 8 a.m. Travis Heights Elementary is a proud community-led in-district charter school. Meeting and hearing from our community and families are the best way to share great news about our school. We have exciting events coming up, and we would love for you to invite your friends, neighbors, and coworkers to attend and learn about these. Join us for the first virtual campus tour through Zoom. No RSVP is needed to attend any of these events. Links will be posted on the Travis Heights Elementary website. Enjoy a cup of coffee, visit with friends, neighbors, and school leaders as you learn about and take a virtual tour through Travis Heights Elementary.
Vamos a continuar con nuestras visitas a los de los padres que gustarían asistir a la escuela Travis Heights. Entonces, nuestro primer tour será virtual, será el 13 de noviembre a las 8 de la mañana y será a través de Zoom. Entonces los invitamos a que vengan ustedes o inviten a familiares o amigos que gustan conocer más de nuestra excelente escuela, que participen en este tour virtual. Otra vez será el 13 de noviembre a las 8 de la mañana.
It's the little things in life that make a huge difference for us, guys. And I'm gonna, I can't say it again. I'll say it again to each and every one of you. Brag on your teacher. Rave about something who has served you well. In Austin ISD, we're committed to building transformational relationships that lead to a sense of trust and belonging for all. We welcome the opportunity to hear the stories that make AISD feel like home. Help us recognize our dedicated staff members by submitting a rave. The recognizing all valuable employees or through the rave program was created to honor those who take the extra steps to provide equitable and exceptional experiences. If you've had an exceptional experience interacting with an Austin ISD employee, please nominate that staff member by completing the form below. Thank you, Ms. Piedra, for throwing that link into the chat. Parents and families, please share that among yourselves. If you want something to spread like wildfire, go ahead and throw that link out there and spread it. Tell the news about how amazing our Travis Heights Elementary teachers are, because it really does. It means a lot to our teachers. It means a lot as administration to hear that what we're doing right and that we are doing right by our community.
Los invitamos a que hagan un RAVE, que es el programa de reconocimiento a todos los empleados valiosos de ISD, o mejor conocido como RAVE. Este programa es para que si tienen cualquier cosa que presumir de su maestro o su maestra, pueden llenar un formulario y el link está en el chat para que se sepa a través del distrito lo excelente que está trabajando su maestro o maestra. Entonces, otra vez, los invitamos a que hagan un RAVE a través del distrito. Es un formulario que se llena y es un reconocimiento especial para todo el trabajo que están haciendo nuestros educadores.
So as we move into the months where we start to celebrate our really amazing traditions at Travis Heights, unfortunately, due to COVID, we're having to be a little bit creative. One specific event in particular is our amazing cultural fest. We want to keep as many of these traditions going even during this unique time. We're going to be exploring and generating ideas on how we can continue this amazing experience that we're able to create and share for all of the amazing cultures that we have here at Travis Heights. So don't be surprised if we are sending more information or we're contacting you to possibly come up with some ideas of how you can share your rich family culture, heritage, tradition with Travis Heights. And we just may have to document it a little bit differently. Unfortunately, we won't be able to have the tamalada this year or the mercado, but there are things that we can look forward to for the coming year. And hopefully, once COVID is done and we're able to tackle this, we'll be able to come once again together and celebrate and share making tamales and eating them together in the cafeteria.
A pesar de COVID-19, estamos tratando de buscar la mejor manera de continuar con nuestras tradiciones aquí en Travis Heights. Como vieron, buscamos la manera de poder tener nuestro carnaval del otoño. Igual estamos buscando la manera de tener nuestro festival de cultura. Estamos viendo diferentes opciones para poder llevar a cabo nuestro festival. No podemos tener la tamalada ni el mercado, pero estamos, como les digo, estamos buscando la manera de poder subrayar todas las culturas que nos hacen, que son, componen a Travis Heights. Entonces, no estén sorprendidos si en unos días estamos buscando ayuda y contactándolos para que puedan mostrar la cultura que tienen.
Like I always say, where there's a will, there's a way. And thankfully, I work with a lot of very strong-willed people. So we'll see where that takes us. Join us next week for a GT presentation and principal update. It'll be at 10 a.m. Friday, November 6th. Look out for the link in the e-folder. We're going to dojo that out. And it'll just be, again, a quick presentation of what the GT process nomination will look like this year and what it typically has for moving forward. So please join us with Ms. Underwood and myself to give an update on what that 100% capacity looks like. Stay tuned. Also, next week is our morning assembly. I live for those. We are so excited. November the 6th, 2020 at 7:35, bright and early. Wake up, join us, rock out with us as we give some appreciation pumps and find out who is going to get the spirit stick. I can't wait to say happy birthday to all my love bugs that are out there. And we will definitely stay tuned and see how things are going.
Los invitamos a que participen en nuestra presentación de nuestro estudiante, el programa de Dotados y Talentosos. Es una sesión para informarles de cómo se verá el proceso este año debido a la pandemia. También los invitamos a que vean o busquen nuestra asamblea que tenemos cada mes, donde los niños celebramos los cumpleaños, celebramos a ver quién va a ganar el Spirit Stick. Entonces, los invitamos a las dos cosas. La presentación de nuestros estudiantes dotados y talentosos será el próximo viernes 6 de noviembre a las 10. Y la asamblea, búsquenla el 6 de noviembre, igual, aproximadamente a las 7:35 de la mañana.
Again, Thunderbirds, thank you. Thank you for all of your support. And let us know how we can continue to serve you and your children and your family best. Stay safe, take care of one another, and hopefully we will see each other real soon.
Bye.